Hi there. I'm Robert Chin, Chief of Head and Neck Radiation Oncology at UCLA. On behalf of our multidisciplinary team, I'm pleased to present our new clinical trial for squamous cell cancers of the head and neck. Traditionally, these cancers were associated with tobacco and alcohol consumption. However, in recent years, we have seen a surge in the proportion of cases involving the oropharynx that are instead associated with the HPV virus. The oropharynx includes the tonsil, base of tongue, soft palate, and pharyngeal wall. This new group of patients tend to be younger, otherwise healthier, and have much, much better response to treatment. Traditional curative therapy has consisted of either surgery or 6 to 7 weeks of radiation treatment. For surgery patients, the tumor specimen is examined for worrisome features. If intermediate risk features are found, this is followed by 6 to 7 weeks of radiation. If high risk features are found, surgery is followed by radiation and chemotherapy given together. For patients who opt for radiation upfront instead of surgery, their treatment may or may not include concurrent chemotherapy based on their cancer staging. While the cure rate with these traditional approaches is excellent, they come with the cost of significant long-term toxicities. In patients with otherwise excellent cure rates, we worry that toxicities of these treatments may be excessive. We wanted a better deal for our patients to find ways to minimize toxicities without compromising cure rates. We worked closely as a multidisciplinary team to redesign the treatment paradigm to specifically address the unique biology of these HPV-associated tumors. We replaced large field radiation to the entire neck with focused radiation to the visible tumor alone. And we reduced our radiation treatment from 7 weeks to 1 week. We replaced traditional chemotherapy with a new class of immunotherapy drugs to help your immune system fight the cancer. And we incorporated transoral robotic surgery in a way that we hope both stimulates anti-tumor immune responses and removes any residual disease. This new treatment option is, of course, experimental, and is being studied as part of a clinical trial at UCLA. We don't know whether it's as effective or safe as standard treatments, and we won't know until the trial is completed. The main inclusion criteria for the study are listed here, though there are additional factors that determine eligibility. If you're interested in learning more about this clinical trial and whether you might qualify, please contact us below. We look forward to hearing from you.